Hello everyone, I'm recording this video after I have recorded a unboxing experience of this Android ebook reader. It's called the Onyx Boox Go 7 or just Boox Go 7. So this is the e-reader which I got instead of my Kindle, which I lost, but I don't regret this too much because this feels like an upgrade in comparison to Kindle, which is quite limited. First of all, because I read the books on different platforms, not only Kindle, but also on Google Play, and sometimes I read stuff online, so I just wanted to have an e-ink device that would support all that, and also to be able to perform other tasks. So, as I've just said in my unboxing experience, in this product, there is pretty nice packaging and a pretty nice case that comes with it. It's a magnetic case, just like in the good old iPad days. So basically that case allows you to keep this device safe. And as you can see, it's not really wearing out. It looks quite good after a week of usage, and I carry it around with me in a bag full of stuff. But yeah, at some point it seemed like a scratch over here and it was lighter, but now it just got like to nothing. So yeah, I really like this cover, and the insides are still looking clean, although I use it everywhere and I put it on different surfaces, but still it's fine. And this is, by the way, on the screen is one of the screensavers which are available for this ebook once it's off. So by default it turns off after 15 minutes of being idle. I don't find it useful because then when you turn it on, it takes really some time for it to load its software. On the other hand, that way it saves the battery, so I will try both ways and I will see which one is better for me. Of course, I got used to using my MacBook or my Mac mini computer always turned on, and that's a convenience that is nice to have, just like with the smartphone. But yeah, it is what it is by default, and I'm following that. So, why did I get this particular device? As I said, because it allows to use multiple apps. So, for example, for reading, it has its own built-in app. It's called... what is it called? Yeah, it's actually like available from the library, from here. And you can... and there is a bookstore where you can buy books. Although this selection is, I mean, it's just classics and some stuff to try out this platform and this device for reading. But I've even never registered Boox account because I'm using third-party apps for reading. So my first reading app of the choice is Google Play Books. It's quite nice. How it works here, and yeah, this is a book I've just finished today, and as you can see, when I've opened the book, it has some traces, some ghosting from the cover of the book, which is easily manageable because I've mapped a full refresh of the screen on this button, and now as you can see, it's nice and clean. So if I want to flip the pages, I can do it with these buttons, which is very convenient when you're holding your ebook like this while reading. And if I want to access this particular application, I just need to swipe down from the center. That's how it works, just like on modern smartphones and tablets. And by the way, this is not the only swiping action in here. Beside that, you have swiping on the edge of the screen, which basically adjusts the brightness. I think there is also a capability of doing it on the other side for adjusting the volume, but I didn't enable that in the settings. Also beside that, you have swipe from the bottom left corner, from where you can access this menu for for different modes of refresh. So the faster it refreshes, the faster it consumes the battery. But yeah, on the other hand, the smoother it works. So yeah, I like it in this HD mode, and there are other settings up here, but I don't go too deep in that. So yeah, if you consider it just like e-reader and also application for browsing, it's very nice, and you can reduce your screen time considerably. So beside the Google Play Books, I'm also using Blinkist from time to time. It's an app where you can access different books, but not the full versions, rather a summarized version of book, and you can either listen to it, which is supported here by the way, or you can read it from here, like read the summary. So let me try to launch the sound. How will it sound from the yours.
Explode the binary. Rich or poor, happy or sad.
Yeah, so
our increasingly polarized society encourages us to ignore new.
And in this application, as you can see, these buttons are serving different purposes now. They control the volume. So yeah, it's also pretty good. I also have Kindle installed here, and it works quite fine. Although I haven't read any book yet with it, but yeah, let me try this one, for example. I already read this on other platform. And yeah, as you can see, the screen updates pretty smoothly. And let's see what's the reading experience. Maybe I will not be able to access this one. Okay, no, this is actually the book, yeah. So yeah, here you can swipe, and you can see just a bit of ghosting, but still, if you use this shortcut to refresh, to do a full refresh of the screen, it's just fine, nothing happens. Also in here, in this part of the screen, you can see this little thing. So it's like a shortcuts for different useful tools within this book. So in here you have the settings for it, actually it's right here, and you can tell which buttons you want to be there. So you have, by default, you have back, full refresh, app optimization, which stands for basically screen optimization and screen refresh rates. You have multitask switcher, just like on modern mobile devices, which is nice in comparison to Kindle. You can kill apps from here, and you also have this button to just hide it if you don't need it. So yeah, that's also useful. What else? With this book, which is not book, which is rather a tablet, you can listen to music. So I installed the YouTube music here. And yeah, let's say we want to listen to this guy. I mean, it doesn't sound good, of course, but you can connect it to your Bluetooth speaker or headphones. You don't have to listen to music with this particular device, but you definitely can do it if you want while reading, which is not my case. You also have voice recorder. You also have this default browser to access internet, which I find pretty fine. And as you can see, when you're launching the browser, the refresh rate of the screen is quite different story from reading and like from Kindle-like experience, because it's quite smooth. Although when the text is not on white background, I don't find it very easy and very pleasing to read, so I wouldn't do that. But yeah, for reading articles on different websites, it's quite okay. And also today I've installed Chrome, which allows me to have recommendations of articles from my Google account. And yeah, okay, Chrome notifications, yeah, go ahead. So this is the example of what an article can look like. This is just a recent one that I started reading here. So as you can see, there is a bit of ghosting as well, but it's easily manageable with this button again. So yeah, I like the experience of reading here pretty much, and I think this is a good replacement for reading from mobile or reading from tablet or whatever. So yeah, and as you can see, there is even video playing on the in-ink screen, which is totally fine here. Yeah, for the overall settings of this home screen for lock capabilities, I don't use it too much because there is this storage for different files. And by the way, you can drop the files from your smartphone to this device just by scanning the QR code in this Boox Drop application. So you scan the QR code, and then you can just send any file to this device from your smartphone, which I successfully used by transferring some images which my son used for learning how to draw, which could be quite useful in some situations. And yeah, beside that, you can basically install any apps with the Google Play. So on Play Store, you have like everything available, and you can download games, you can download different applications. I don't find it very useful. I have installed chess.com to try it out, but so far I don't like the optimization of the app. Maybe I'll have to tweak it a bit more because it doesn't look contrast enough for me, the user interface and also the chessboard itself. So let's try with the puzzle, for example. Yeah, as you can see, I mean, it's fine, but I feel like it could be better and also take all the screen real estate. Maybe there is an option for that in this app. And also there is yeah, you have like Google apps like Google Sheets. They look just fine, just like, you know, Sheets. And you have default music app. Yeah, Push Reader, I haven't used that. And yeah, some settings for the screensaver. You have default calculator, which I don't find useful, even though it's quite big. But yeah, you have it on mobile as well. Yeah, that's it. That's it regarding the software. There is also an AI assistant that also requires to have the Boox account, which I don't have yet, and I'm not really interested in this because there is ChatGPT and Grok on my laptop, which is completely fine for me, completely sufficient. And over here there is an interesting setting. It's hidden under this snowflake icon. So it's there in order to optimize the battery usage of the app. And basically it you can tell the device which apps to freeze on the background and which not. So for example, in the Blinkist app, you're listening to books. And if you want to listen on the background, you have to exclude the app from that list, like turn off that feature. Otherwise, if we're going here, and if we're starting to play
that, think in black and white binaries, but ideas and creativity thrive in shades of gray.
That's the other way around. It should have stopped, or maybe it'll stop over time. But yeah, that's the setting for that. And yeah, those are the main features of this device. There are, as you can see, a handful of settings for the security, for the language, for gestures. This one I think is particularly interesting because you can switch to different styles of the navigation. So by default I'm using this swipe navigation, but you can also have the bottom bar like this, yeah, like more classical Android. And then you have those settings available. Yeah, maybe I should keep it, by the way, because it's more predictable for using on the touch screen with the on the e-ink touch screen. So I like it maybe better. And yeah, you can have different swipes from different areas, and you can also have the sides to control volume, control brightness. So yeah, let's not touch that. And you can have screenshot action by swiping with three fingers, which looks quite advanced, like Apple style. stuff. So yeah, Boox did a great job on this device in my opinion, and I think that it works exploring even further. So yeah, let me know your thoughts in the comments, and please subscribe to see my future videos and reviews on other gadgets, and maybe some additional videos on my experience with this device. And yeah, looking forward to your thoughts. Thanks.